I remember the day very vividly. It was February 18th, 2020, when the 99 Songs trailer had dropped. I was so fascinated by its aesthetic and theme that I kept on watching the trailer. What intrigued me more was that Ehan Rahman, more than just composing the music of the film, had also written and produced it. While putting the piece on loop consistently and contributing to its rising views, I was drawn to its enchanting music. Oh Ashika played in the background of the trailer and I couldn't help but get goosebumps. How epic is this film going to be? 99 Songs broadly focuses on the self-exploration of an artist, the journey of a man who wants to find the truth in his art form. A journey that commences due to one doubting an artist's capabilities and the several revelations that follow while he goes in the path of finding the magic in his craft, while at the same time understand his roots and motivations. I can only be this vague as I describe you this film, because it is a cinematic experience that has to be felt more than anything else. While the current predicament we are in leads to many of us not having the luxury to watch it, I can't wait to join in and rave about it with all of you as it drops on Netflix very soon. Here's me telling you the good and bad aspects of the film so that you guys can ultimately decide whether to watch 99 Songs when things are a bit normal on a streaming platform or not. The underwhelming aspects. Incoherence is evident. What a story regarding an artist and his expression lends is that it will be all-encompassing. So if you are extremely analytical about Ehan Rahman's storytelling, you will probably be frustrated at the several subplots it explores. I was absolutely transfixed in every shape and form. This is just me simply acknowledging the fact that criticism lies in the fact that Jay's journey in the film goes from self-confidence, doubt, exploration, a sense of madness within, and honing the truth in one's craft. And these pillars are essentials in a theme like 99 Songs. But the journey also entails the impact of a song that can change the universe. And this is where I acknowledge the intention, but the execution goes rather over the top. The dreamer within me wanted to surrender to the capability of any art form and its global impact. But the film and its second half definitely elevates it to a notch. Whereas an audience member, especially pessimists or realists, can be disconnected to this far-fetched idea. This is also a film where the resolutions to the conflict within an artist's life are dealt with solutions that come fairly easily. While this moves on the story, it also is rather convenient from a screenplay perspective. Anyway, enough cribbing. Now let me dream and tell you why I was so enamored by this piece. The good. Musical in its truest sense. You know, a lot of people have this misconception that we produce musical in its truest sense just because we have songs in our movies. If you look at commercial Bollywood, music has more or less simply become a marketing tool. And in a lot of instances, even in Tamil and Telugu films, they act as item pieces for the hooting and cheering in theaters. The ability of the music to be a key factor in the film's storytelling and moving it forward denotes it to be a musical in its truest sense. And we are slowly seeing this diminishing. So Hrithik and Tiger dancing on Jai Jai Shiv Shankar has nothing to do with the impending mission at hand, whereas the opening sequence of La La Land is precisely there to give us an essence of the artistic world of Los Angeles and prepare us for the organized chaos ahead. I think one of the main reasons why a lot of people did not connect with 99 Songs is because they did not understand why emotional turmoil within a character is denoted through interpretive dance and silk work, why the movie in the process of self-exploration always transitioned to the metaphysical. All these aspects that make this film, as the title suggests, weird, trippy, and beautiful, are actually the reasons why I fell in love with it. I'll get to that now. The music and visuals. I remember the time when a batchmate of mine had busted bounds from school to watch the 2011 Rockstar. Both of us being Bollywood buffs, I had asked him about what he felt about it. He seemed to be at a loss for words. Both of us being artists, I could understand the impact of the movie, but he just provided clarity on one front. He said that he had not felt so many things ever in a film just because of the movie's music. Everyone who witnessed Kun Faya Kun in theaters will tell you exactly where they were and what they were going through when Ranbir Kapoor, with a lost gaze, looked up to the sky. 99 Songs and its album is to be truly felt because it is special in so many ways. The naivety or the birth of an artist with Nai Nai, pure love and affection through Teri Nazar, processing hurt and turmoil through Jwalamukhi, and finally the grand conclusion with O Ashika. The album itself takes you on a journey, and I understand that many of you may think this is pseudo-intellectualism, but it is me surrendering to the vision of the maestro, and I somehow got simply lost in his world. The cinematography by Tane Satam is in another league altogether with this film. While Shillong has been beautifully captured, especially its natural and expansive setting, it is in the sequence where the music manifests different different energies where the movie will take you to another dimension. The ability of a cinematographer to capture the mental state of a character can be technically showcased in many ways. So be it Rue from Euphoria going through a psychedelic trip and the room moving as if experiencing it with her brain, or you see Black Swan, a compelling tale on an artist's journey again, and how the journey of self-destruction manifests into Nina imagining herself turning into a swan. 99 Songs in many ways communicates the inner turmoil of Jay, the want to seek for the truth that he was never provided, and all of this manifests in sequences that may seem bizarre, but actually denote how a character processes their current predicament. Casting. Ehan Bhat as Jay is such a find. I know many of you may remember him as the guy in Chhod Denge with Nora Fatihi, but with this performance, you know the man has such a bright future ahead. Ehan communicates the inner strife of an artist with beautiful conviction, and the vulnerability transitioning to the intensity of his eyes that wants to prove the naysayers wrong make him the perfect vessel to tell A.R. Rahman's story. The female lead, Adelie Vargas, puts forth a commendable performance as well. The chemistry that both of them share was lightning in a bottle. And it was so great to see two new faces provided an opportunity to tell the legend's story. The supporting cast in the form of Lisa Ray, Manisha Koirala, and especially Polo's family in Shillong assimilated perfectly in the film. Tenzing Dala, another actor who you may have seen in films like Guilty and Akune, is such a bright prospect. He kills it in basically everything I've seen him in. Polarizing reactions. This film is definitely one of those that will separate the realists and the dreamers. This is one of those films that will either test your patience or transfix you from the onset. You know, a lot of people who saw the journey of musical artists, be it in the 2011 Rockstar or even a light-hearted but technically brilliant film We Are Your Friends, a lot of people consider these stories of artists and the journey of self-discovery to be pretentious. But I'll let that kind of judgment be and be truthful with the fact that I resonate so much with the inner battle of an artist and their journey to prove what they do is credible and of value. The journey calls for a sense of narcissism as artists and their craft require time. All that doesn't have the luxury to accommodate others. This self-destruction often pushes away people and leaves a sense of hollowness from within. But 99 Songs beautifully keeps the core. The loving relationship between Sophie and Jay as its nucleus, an avenue of peace, a place that they can call home. As Ehan said, "Main wapas aaunga tujhe lene," it literally gave me vibes of Galat aur Sahi ke paar ek maidan hai. I can assure you that this is one of those films that artists will revisit again and again and hold a special place in their heart for the clarity with which it communicates so many facets of their journey. I can't wait for all of you to see it. And that was the video, guys. Write down in the comments below what you thought about the movie. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle's right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.